Hello, ladies and gents, and welcome to another episode of Cycling Insider. In this episode of Cycling Insider, let's talk about another bike from Scott, and this time it's going to be a super bike. This is the 2020 Scott Addict RC10. Before we start, I just want to say that we are truly living in extraordinary times because of the coronavirus, and I truly hope that you are well and that your family members are well. Please stay safe. So without further ado, let's jump in and let's see what is it all about this Scott Addict RC10 for 2020 season. As I said, this is a superbike. You'll see the components on this bike, you'll of course see the price of this bike, and you'll definitely understand why I think it's a category of superbikes. When you look at the Scott Addict RC range, these are the lightweight bikes from Scott, these are the climbing machines, these are basically the bikes that pros would use when you look at all the grand tours. And also these are the lightest bikes that Scott is currently doing. You got two paint schemes for this bike. One is this gray, kind of metallic silver paint scheme, and then you have this Scott Addict in red paint scheme. And I'll be focusing on the red bike today, because as you all know, red is the fastest color. I mean, jokes aside, this is a beautiful paint scheme, red and black, classical choice of paint schemes. But as I said, even if you want to go with the gray one, which is kind of metallic silver, it also looks beautiful. So let's kick off with the price of the bike. So this is 4,400 British pounds bike. That's why I'm saying it's a super bike. It's definitely top range bike, and you really gotta be dedicated to go and buy this bike. If we quickly calculate this into US dollars, this should be something about $5,400 for all the people across the pond. So that's why I'm saying this is definitely a category of a super bike. But let's see, what do you get for this 4,400 British pounds. I'll kick off with the frame and fork. Here we have a Scott's Addict RC HMX frame and fork, so carbon fiber frame and fork, and this is the top level HMX carbon fiber that Scott Bikes does. I mean, Scott generally produces top-notch carbon fiber frames and forks, and one interesting thing that I noticed by researching about this bike is that when you look at the warranty of Scott bikes, they are offering a 5-year warranty on the frames. But funnily enough, when you look a bit more into details, it seems like they are only offering 2 years warranty for the fork. I truly hope that on this superbike, Scott would allow 5 years warranty on the frame and fork. I mean, after all, this is the HMX level of carbon fiber, their top level. So the lightest, stiffest, everything, best of the best. So I think they should have it 5 years for frame and fork. But this is definitely something to check if you are in the market for this bike. And if you are testing this bike, please do speak with your local Scott bike dealer just to be sure. Moving on, when we look at the group set, this is where the bike truly shines. So we got a rear mech, front mech, and the shifters. Everything is Shimano Dura-Ace mechanical group set. For me, Shimano Dura-Ace is absolutely peak of shifting performance. Nobody comes close, and this is the Dura-Ace 9100 22 speed group set. I mean, absolutely top of the top. As I said, rear mech, front mech, and the shifters, everything is Shimano Dura-Ace. Crankset on the bike is also Shimano Dura-Ace, R9100. It's a Holotech Shimano crankset, 5236 chainrings, and quickly paired with Shimano Ultegra cassette 1130. So you see 1130 cassette, 5236 chainrings. You will be able to climb some steep mountains, but you'll need to produce some decent power. If this cassette is too small for you, You can always upgrade to something like 1132 cassette later. Shimano Ultegra cassette, of course, they cut it a little bit of corners here. Hopefully they could have included Shimano Dura-Ace cassette, but again, this is not a big problem, because once when you destroy this cassette, you should be able to switch to something like Shimano Dura-Ace. When it comes to chain, it's also Shimano Ultegra chain, 11-speed chain. Again, a little cutting corners here. I wish they included Shimano Dura-Ace chain, but again, when you destroy this one together with the cassette, you can switch to the Shimano Dura-Ace chain. A bottom bracket is the Shimano's Press Fit bottom bracket, BB92. Shimano usually doesn't have any big problems with press fit bottom brackets, so you should be totally fine here. Brakes on the bike are another highlight, because here we got again hydraulic disc brakes, Shimano Dura-Ace hydraulic disc brakes, again peak of braking performance, top of the top, creme de la creme, absolutely the best hydraulic brakes you can get on the market. This is the Shimano's BR-R9170 hydraulic brakes, 160mm rotors both front and back, and finally they've included these RT900 central lock rotors, so absolutely no cutting corners here. When it comes to handlebar, stem, seat post, and seat even, these are all Syncros products. So Syncros is a kind of in-house brand of squad bikes. They produce some decent products. It's a similar kind of relationship like Trek would have with their Bontrager parts. On the seat here, I don't see them mentioning it's a carbon fiber seat post. I truly hope it is, because I would expect on this level of bike that it is a carbon fiber seat post. When it comes to wheel set, this is an interesting choice. We got a Syncros wheelset, Syncros RP2.0, front and rear, with true axles, of course. And this wheelset, from the data I could find, is an aluminium wheelset. So when you look at the Syncros' webpage, Syncros RP2.0, this is an aluminium wheelset. So I was hoping they could have included a carbon fiber wheelset, but probably it would push the price too high. The good thing with this wheel set is that it uses the DT Swiss internals for the hubs, so it should be a pretty decent wheel set. Moving on, when we look at the tires, here we have Schwalbe tires, one race tire, 28C, very interesting that they've included 28C tires, not the 25mm tires. In my opinion, this is a good choice. I always prefer a bit wider tires, just because you can get a bit more air volume inside, and excuse me, and your whole ride will be much smoother. Total weight of the bike is 7.83 kilograms. So I definitely can't say it's a light bike. I'm guessing this is the bike weight for the size 56. So thinking always that professional bikes are going down to 6.8 kilograms, but this is a disc brake bike, so 7.8 kilograms is decent, but I can't say anything special here. So to make a little summary, as I said, this is definitely a category of a super bike, Scott Addict RC10, because when you think about the price, £4,400, you truly have to be dedicated. Some of the key features of this bike: carbon fiber frame and fork, and this is the level of HMX carbon fiber, so top of the line that Scott Bikes does. Also, we have the Shimano Dura-Ace group set, so absolutely top of the line mechanical group set. So everything from the shifters, front mech and rear mech, everything is Shimano Dura-Ace mechanical. And also we have Shimano Dura-Ace hydraulic disc brakes, which again, in my opinion, is the top of the braking performance in road bikes. Wheelset, Syncros wheelset, aluminium wheelset. This is something to think about in the future of upgrading, and the other small parts on the bikes are on the bike are also from the Syncros in-house production. So all in all, if you have this amount of money and you are truly dedicated, you should definitely go and test this bike with your local Scott bike dealer. And in my opinion, you should also negotiate with your local bike dealer for the price of this bike, because I truly believe that you should get approximately 10 to 15% discount if you negotiate nicely and, of course, behave nicely. So I think this is gonna be it for today. I hope you like what I'm doing. If you do, please do subscribe. I'll be making more of these videos, and as always, I will see you soon in the next episode. Pura vida!